Does it make sense? All right. Okay. So to summarize the method of bias stabilization, what did we do? We basically are comparing the drain current with the reference current and tweaking the gate voltage. All right. But remember that in a MOS transistor, there are, and what did we, how did we do this? We had the transistor and we stuck and we measured the drain current, correct? But remember that in a MOS transistor, the gate current is 0. So, what comment can you make about the drain current and the source current? So, in other words, if the gate current is 0, it must follow that the drain current and the source current are identical. So, in principle, there was no compulsion to stick that ammeter in the drain. We could have as well put it in the source, correct? All right. And remember that the gate source voltage, I mean the current in the transistor is governed by the gate source voltage, not the absolute gate voltage. It depends on the gate source voltage. And what we did was, earlier we measured the current in the drain and varied the gate source voltage by keeping the source voltage fixed and wiggling the gate, correct? I mean, what are the fundamental ways of wiggling? I mean, how can you change the gate source voltage? I can think of at least 3 ways of doing it. What are the 3 ways? One is to fix the VS, wiggle the gate. That's what we've done, right? The other is fix the gate, wiggle the source, right? Okay. What is the third way? Vary both, right? To push the gate up, pull the gate source down, correct? Similarly, we can measure the whole idea behind feedback was measure the current in the transistor and tweak the gate source voltage in the right direction, correct? So, we can measure in 2 places, right? Namely, you can either stick the ammeter in the drain or the ammeter in the source, correct? So, the 2 ways of measuring, the quiescent current in the transistor, right? There are 2 ways of, at least 2 ways of varying the gate source voltage in the right direction to make sure that ID or the quiescent current in the transistor is equal to IRF. So, how many, what are the minimum number of techniques you can think of to stabilize the bias in the transistor? We can think of at least 4 ways of doing it, right? So, you measure in the drain, you vary VGS by keeping the source fixed and varying the gate potential. That is what we have done now, correct? All right? You have all the other, you know, permutations and combinations. We can measure current in the source, vary the source voltage. We can measure current in the drain, vary the source voltage, okay, and so on. So, we will take a look at all of them, but today we will look at the second example, which is, let us now measure. So, this way of doing this, this is measure drain current vary VGS by keeping the source at a constant potential. And vary VG. All right. So now let's take a look at a system where we keep the gate voltage fixed, VG is fixed. So VDD, how do we fix VG? Well, one way of doing it is to simply put a some kind of potential divider. This is R1. And what will we do? We want to measure source current vary VGS by keeping VG constant and change VS. So the basic idea therefore is like this. So this is the ammeter and this is our variable voltage source, correct? So and what we are measuring is ID, which is the same as IS, correct? So common sense, what are we going to do? Can somebody tell me a clean step by step way of finding the correct magic VS? So yeah, for a given VS, right, so apply an arbitrary VS, there will be some current ID that will be result, okay. Then what? Compare ID with IREF. So if ID is greater than IREF, what does it mean? VG is fixed, you can't mess with VG, the only thing you have is VS. ID greater than IREF means what? It means that the gate source voltage is too much or too little, means VGS is too high. Which means VS is too low. So what must you do? Must increase VS. All right. So in other words, if ID greater than IREF, must increase VS. On the other hand, if ID is less than IREF, what must we do? What does it mean? If ID is less than IREF, it means that VGS is too small, but VG is fixed. So it must mean that VS is too high and therefore we must reduce VS. Is that clear? Okay. So now the basic idea is known. What are we supposed to do therefore? We must compare ID and IREF. So what physical principle will be used to compare two currents? KCL again. So this is ID or IS, okay. How do we compare it? You connect a current source here. All right. Okay. Now what? So this is ID. This is IREF. That's the potential of node X. Okay. If ID is greater than IREF, what comment can you make about the potential of node X, more current, more charge is being pumped into the node than is being withdrawn from the node, right? Okay. All right. Then what comment can we make? If ID is greater than IREF, VX will tend to go up. All right. So, in other words, if VX goes up, we must increase VS, which is the same as X, right? All right. The potential of node X must be increased. Okay. And if ID is less than IREF, what does it mean? What will happen if ID is less than IREF? VX will fall down, but that's what we needed to do anyway. Correct? So, what do you suggest we do? There is nothing to be done. The very act of simply sticking that current source in the source of the transistor automatically ensures that the current in the transistor is exactly equal to IREF. Okay? If you are not convinced, take a look, just think about it this way. Let us say momentarily for some reason ID has suddenly increased. Okay. Then what comment can you make about VX? It will also increase and therefore tend to reduce the gate source voltage and bring the current down. Does it make sense? Again, you can see that even though it is not evident, all right, unless you think about it, there is negative feedback here too, just like there was in the case with the diode. All right. I mean, negative feedback doesn't. I mean, you know, you most likely looked at negative feedback as a block diagram, right? Forward amplifier, feedback block, you subtract, right? Okay. In the real world, negative feedback life doesn't come in block diagrams. Okay. It is all there. Okay, I mean, you know, everything that we are doing is basically feedback, but you know, you don't see that the forward amplifier, feedback block, all that is, it does not come labeled, right? It is for you to sit, think carefully and recognize what is going, all right? So basically, this will ensure that the current in the transistor is equal to IREF. I mean, and some of you may be wondering, you know, well, this is so self-evident, right? Why is this all this strange analysis needed, right? Isn't Kirchhoff's law simply telling you that IRF is equal to, you know, ID? I mean, what is all this, you know, long-winded argument? Why did we have to even derive it like this? And the answer to that is that such arguments can be very deceptive. Okay, so here is an example. Here is an experiment. The transistor's properties are known. Mu n C aux W by L is 2 milliamps per volt square. Vt is 1 volt. And I am applying 2 volts here. This is VDD, which is sufficiently large. And I stick an ammeter here. What will the reading on the ammeter be? Yes, people? 1 milliamp. Very good. Okay. All right. Now, I am going to do another experiment. Same transistor. This is 1 milliampere current source. and I put a voltmeter there. So, what will the voltmeter read? So, the crucial point that we are missing here when we do that is that, remember that the MOS transistor is a unilateral device. Why do we say a MOS transistor is a unilateral device? What is the cause and what is the effect? VG is the cause and ID is the effect, right? Okay, just because there is a relationship between VGS and ID, right, doesn't mean that you can go and turn the relationship the other way and then expect that you push a current into the drain and a voltage will develop at the gate. All right, and how do we know that the transistor is a unilateral device? Y12, which quantifies the effect of an excitation at the output at the drain on the input port, we know that Y12 is 0, right? So that basically means that, you know, wiggling the drain doesn't magically cause voltage at the gate, right? So if you do this experiment, you will burn the transistor because the voltage at the drain will go to infinity and it will break the transistor. Okay. Another way of thinking about it is that, you study hard and then your CGPA hopefully reflects what you know, correct? But if I take a blank grade card and print, CGPA of 10.2 on the grade card, doesn't suddenly mean that fundas will come into your mind from, outer space. You understand, right? Okay. This is the, though you'd be tempted to use Kirchhoff's law at the drain and say, we know the equation and put the stuff in and then conclude that VGS is 2 volts, that's certainly not true. All right. So, we'll stop here.